Hey guys, welcome to my channel. It's Tripti here, and today's video is going to be another book review. But before that, I was not supposed to make this video until next week, but then yesterday I found such great deals on books that I couldn't stop myself from sharing all those details with you. Before starting, if you have not subscribed my channel, please do subscribe and do not forget to hit the bell icon as well. Okay, now moving on, you must be aware there is some great sale is going on Amazon, and fortunately there is a sale on books section as well. So yesterday I was just scrolling down and I found great books, and just for minimal prices. I mean prices as low as rupees 49. So it is a great deal. I will leave the links below. There are several book sets as well which are of minimal prices. Do check them out. I will leave the link below in the description box. You can go through it and check them out. So today's book is Karna's Wife, and just like Sita's sister, this title as well was very much intriguing to me. Actually, all of Kavita Kane's titles are very much, you know, mysterious. Not exactly mysterious, I would say eye-catching. Yeah, they are very much eye-catching, because the characters that she picks, I feel those characters are the most shadowed characters in our mythology. And similarly, Karan's wife was also one of the neglected characters, and for that matter, even Karan was very much neglected at that time. So the main character's name is Urvi. So she was the princess of Pukea, if I am pronouncing it right. And during that time, you know, women of higher caste were not allowed to marry someone from the lower caste. And Karan being the Sutputra, which actually he was not, but then again, everyone believed it to be. So she fell in love with Karan, and despite all the odds and against all the restrictions that were put on her, she broke all the barriers and finally married him. This book is not just about the love story of Karan and Urvi. This book is so much more. It's like reading a mini Mahabharat. You know, you'll complete the whole Mahabharat within just 200 pages. There are some, I don't want to give you any spoilers, but there are some great points which I was not even aware about, and I was like, really? That happened? I mean, seriously? I was kind of awestruck, dumbstruck at that point of time, and those times came quite often in this book, believe me. That is why I'm saying it is a complete page turner. You all guys must be aware of how Pandavas were born, and to be very honest, I still, till the time I read this book, I kind of had that belief what my parents have told me, that, you know, gods arrived and they blessed her with the child. Just that's it, you know, when we tell kids that we have got your brother or your sister from the hospital, in spite of actually telling what. You know what I mean, right? So, I got to know about this Niyog Pratha, which was very common at that point of time. It is like, you know, wives are allowed to conceive a child from another man with the permission of her husband. Really? Okay, at that time it used to happen. So, all the Pandavas were born through this Niyog Pratha. You know, you get to know a lot of ancient prathas that used to happen at that point of time, and that is why I really appreciate Kavita Kane's research work. She had actually put in a lot of effort to come out with these books. And like I said, there are certain jaw-dropping points as well. So if you are going to read it, actually I would really advise you to read it and pay focus on... I'm not giving any spoilers, just... pay your focus on Kunti, the mother of Pandavas, Draupadi, of course, she is in the limelight. She has always been in the limelight. But here you get to see another side which I was not aware of. It is a fiction, but then, you know, I kind of feel that it might be true, you know. Anyways, yeah, so keep an eye on all these characters. At the end, after finishing the book, what I really felt was that no one, not even a single person, was sane during Mahabharat. All the characters, especially, no, I'm not giving any spoilers. Okay, I am not giving any spoilers. It's just people whom you think they are innocent and they are just victims. Well, actually, they are not. It may be because this book actually focuses on Karan and Karan's wife. But I honestly feel that these two, especially Karan, was the righteous man at that point of time. Apart from him, I don't think any man, any woman was sane, and not even Krishna. But yeah, we can leave him apart because he was the god and he was doing all that, so not judging him. But then apart from him, not the Pandavas, not the Kauravas, nobody was right on their part. Seriously, I really felt bad for Karan. You know, I was thinking when I started this channel, I went through a lot of other booktubers, and I actually heard them talking that they cry while reading the book, and I was wondering when was the last time that I cried. I must tell you that this book made me cry. I mean, I was surprised as well that I was crying. It takes a lot of, you know, efforts for a writer to write things like that, that the person who is reading it is feeling it so strongly that he or she starts crying. I really appreciate Kavita Kane's work. You know, she replied to my video last time when I made it. I just hope she likes this as well. And ma'am, I'm a true fan of yours. So yes, guys, definitely go for this book if you are into mythology. And forget mythology, if you are into mythology or not in it, this book will definitely get you starting more of mythological books. I will leave a link down below of the great deals that I thought you should be aware of. I actually ordered 20 books and I'll be coming up with a huge book haul. So I am sure it will be beneficial for you as well. And along with that, I will leave a link for this book. And another thing is, yeah, if you want to buy more of Kavita Kane's book, then there is a book set of 3 books. I would really like you to recommend it to you guys. Check out the link below and go and buy it and read it and let me know how you like it. And that's it. Give me a thumbs up if you like the video. Bye.